Hi, my name is Merle and I'm a field application engineer at Blackbox. Today I'm excited to give you a brief overview of our Emerald KVM over IP matrix switching system. With me today is Max. He is a solutions architect at Blackbox and will guide us through the system. Hi, Max, and thanks for being here.
Hi, Merle. Thanks for having me today.
Let's take a closer look at the Emerald system. Emerald is our high-performance KVM over IP system that our team in Ireland has engineered to overcome the limitations of legacy KVM matrix approaches, such as scalability and cost. Max, could you walk us through the main components of the system?
Of course, Merle. The primary components of the system are as follows. IP-based KVM transmitters that connect to computers or so-called targets. This differs based on required performance in terms of maximum supported resolution, HD or 4K, number of video heads, 1 or 2, native video input, such as a DVI and display port, form factor, rack and desk mountable or 0U dongles, picture quality, pixel perfect or visually lossless, port redundancy, and others. KVM receivers at the workstations that are connected to the monitors, audio, keyboard, mouse, and other USB peripherals. Emerald receivers are able to connect not only to the hardware transmitters, but also directly to virtual machines. Similarly to the transmitters, Emerald receivers also come in many flavors to meet your specifications. The Emerald Remote app for Windows, a unique software which turns any Windows 10 or 11 device into a user workstation and allows for KVM access over the internet. The Emerald GE Gateway leverages RDP, PC over IP, or PC over IP Ultra protocols to allow users simultaneous access to a virtual machine. An Emerald GE can be placed anywhere on the Emerald network to allow multiple users VM sharing. Boxilla KVM Manager and its web interface, which allows you to centrally manage the deployment of any size and complexity. It enables for seamless integration with your IT system such as Active Directory, Syslog, REST API control, and many more. Boxilla does allow for active standby redundancy mode. However, we will later explain how Emerald ensures KVM persistent functionality even when both managers go offline. In addition, Blackbox offers a portfolio of enterprise Ethernet switches, controlled and managed by Boxilla. Though you can use third-party switches, using Blackbox switches allows for a turnkey KVM solution. USB companions that provide high-speed USB connectivity of up to 480 megabits per second if the Emerald Endpoint's native 50 megabits per second of USB throughput is not enough. The Freedom Desktop keyboard and mouse switches that provide switching between separate computers and desktops simply by moving a mouse cursor from monitor to monitor. Control Bridge touchscreens offer a user-friendly interface for managing and automating switching of Emerald transmitters and receivers with a single touch by communicating with Boxilla over REST API. And of course, the peripheral equipment such as rack mount kits, power hubs, SFP modules, cables and adapters.
Thank you, Max. Now let's break it down piece by piece. Why should I select Emerald Endpoints?
Merle, the Emerald Endpoints provide great flexibility for KVM switching and extension setups of any complexity. Let's take the example of a broadcast production facility. To begin, Emerald enables users at various workstations, desktops, or in a master control room to view and control content and software the way they prefer. Users are no longer limited to the classic monitor, keyboard, and mouse connectivity from legacy KVM systems. Emerald supports a variety of input devices and methods. Classic USB HID devices such as keyboards, mice, and other controllers are of course a very common way of interacting with computers, and Emerald supports share and remote connections over USB. Additionally, both USB audio and USB sound drives can be connected as well to support editing suites and other remote workspaces, for example. Access to the USB ports can be restricted per machine to avoid unnecessary security risks.
We know from our customers that Wacom tablet can be extremely useful for editors, VFX artists, and graphic designers. Low latency ensures a pleasant experience and accuracy when working with the high precision equipment.
X keys can be key for operational efficiency in broadcast facilities. Emerald allows both controlling the target server as well as manipulating operation of KVM device itself. One key may open a new app on the server while the other switches a receiver to a new computer.
Some of our customers also use touchscreen-based input, which helps them to create any desired workflow for the operator, including fast access to automated processes and macros. Besides OSD and X keys, are there more ways to control automated switching between computers and workstations?
Yes, there are. KVM administrators can force switching using the Boxilla Manager's web interface. In addition, the comprehensive REST API allows Emerald to integrate with various orchestration systems, such as Leva VSM. Also, the Black Box Control System touchscreen control bridge provides you with that capability. You can use a wired touchscreen or simply an Android or iOS app on your mobile device to monitor who is logged in from a given user workplace, as well as to switch it to a different target.
And what if my workflow requires simultaneous connections from multiple user workplaces to the same exact computer?
For this scenario, Emerald offers two different modes of accessing computer, the so-called shared and view-only modes. Multiple users may connect to a given computer and observe or even control it together.
Another key topic is display resolution. Many of our customers are moving to 4K production while they still deliver HD streams to the network. What about HD and 4K interoperability? If the installed Emerald setup supports 4K, am I limited to 4K transmitters and target servers?
Not at all. I am now connected to a 4K transmitter device. Using the on-screen display or the X key, I can switch to a Windows 10 virtual machine using RDP. In the same fashion, I will connect to the HD transmitter with macOS as a target. As you see, the workflow is seamless and completely agnostic to the underlying technical factors, whether HD or 4K, copper or fiber, Apple, Windows, Linux, or even a virtual machine, it will still work. Additionally, because the system communicates based on the IP protocol, it will also allow you to expand the KVM system gradually across many locations.
Since Emerald is a KVM over IP system, can I use it for over the internet scenario?
Absolutely. Emerald platform can be configured for a low bandwidth usage that can support hybrid workplaces in the best manner. Remote users can connect via VPN, LAN, WAN, or internet, getting the same user experience as their local colleagues.
That's great news, and I think this brings a lot of flexibility to Emerald installations. Talking of which, you mentioned the Emerald software that turns your laptop into a KVM receiver.
The Emerald Remote app does precisely that, Merle. You can use your Windows 10 or 11 device and display up to four physical or virtual targets at the same time. Here, I have connected my laptop to an Emerald KVM network over Wi-Fi, but I can get the same experience when VPN in from home as long as the network latency is acceptable. Just like with a physical receiver, the remote app will accept your KVM or Active Directory credentials and provide you with connections to both hardware KVM transmitters as well as virtual machines.
Do I need to buy an app for each laptop I use?
The software is license-based. You can install the app on as many devices as you want. The Boxilla KVM Manager will count the number of concurrent remote app connections from all the users.
Let's talk about expanding an Emerald network. How do you add new KVM devices to your system?
This is done in a few simple steps. Log in to the Boxilla web interface using a browser of your choice. first, you will need to discover the endpoint. Next, configure its network settings according to the desired IP scheme. Once done, you can now manage the device. After I name it, the KVM endpoint is added to the database. In addition, if the KVM receiver or transmitter endpoint was kept in your storage for a while, chances are it is running an old firmware. In this case, I can upgrade my endpoint to match with the rest of my deployment. I go to Devices, Upgrades. I upload and activate the firmware version downloaded from the Blackbox website. Now I can select the endpoints to get upgraded, click Upgrade, and wait a couple minutes until the upgrade is finished. If you decide to use Blackbox Ethernet switches for your Emerald deployment, the Switches tab will show you which port a given endpoint is connected to, as well as its network statistics.
Seems pretty straightforward. Now that I have added my Emerald endpoints, can I use the KVM system?
Almost. We suggest you create users and specify the computers that they are allowed to access. You can do this in a few steps. Go to Users, Manage, and create a new user. Select the user's privilege, Admin, General User, Power User. You can also enable the user to auto-connect to a predefined computer upon login, and allow this user to employ the Emerald Remote app. Finally, you should select the connections or groups of connections this user will be eligible to access. If you want, you may also streamline the user's workflow by adding the hotkey connections for fast switching between the targets.
What if I need to limit access to a certain target from a secure location?
For that, we introduce a zoning feature. The concept is that users in different locations are required to use their login, but may have different security access levels or requirements depending on the location. You can use zoning to associate each physical receiver and each physical or virtual connection with a zone.
That's a great security feature. With that said, how does Emerald fit in the overall corporate infrastructure?
In addition to locally created users, you can pull a user database from Active Directory. The concept is straightforward. Add the specific OU or security group into the KVM manager and link it to the KVM connection group. Now, any user belonging to the OU will be granted access to the list of physical and virtual KVM targets. The user will receive targets on their OSD list that are dependent on the location or zone they are currently working in. Finally, the Boxilla KVM Manager allows you to log events with syslog, send email notifications for specific events, and of course interact with the KVM system and customers' infrastructure using a rich set of API.
I know that many KVM systems rely heavily on a specific KVM controller, and if it fails, the entire KVM system ceases functioning. Is that the case with the Emerald?
Emerald does not have this single point of failure. Firstly, you can deploy a pair of active standby Boxilla managers with automatic switchover. But most importantly, in case both KVM managers go offline, the user may not even notice it. Every time a user logs into a receiver, this receiver downloads the entire Boxilla database to include users and connections. Thus, the users will still be able to log in and establish connections despite the Boxilla being disconnected.
Thank you so much, Max, for explaining to us some of the system's highlights. I know that Emerald comes with so many features and is built for such a variety of applications that it's hard to cover all of them in one video.
You're very welcome, and yes, you're absolutely right. And since at times the deployment of such a system might seem complicated, I would like to assure our viewers that Blackbox will be available before, during, and after any deployment to to help building and maintaining a reliable and secure KVM network.
Thanks again, Max. If you would like to know more about Emerald, please visit blackbox.com/Emerald. See you next time, and thanks for watching.